Hello everyone, Brick Waffle here. As you might be able to tell right away, I've got a new microphone, so hopefully that will help the quality of these videos a little bit. Today what I wanted to show you though is a very quick and easy redstone disposal that uses lava, a dropper, and a comparator pulse clock to easily get rid of items you no longer need. So the first thing I want to do is show you how this works. If I just grab something like a stack of cobblestone here, you'll see that if I add it to the dropper, it's going to pulse through and start throwing that all into the lava until it's gone. So this is fairly easy to build. I'm going to take that out just to stop the noise here, and I'm going to show you how that works. You can also use this with a hopper and a chest to throw items into a chest and have a very convenient disposal system. You can see that's ticking away and disposing of them as well. It's the same system underneath, but really all you need to build this are the materials you can see in my hotbar here. So you'll need one dropper, one comparator, two repeaters, six pieces of redstone, one lava bucket, and for the optional version, if you want to really conceal it, a hopper and a chest. So I'm going to show you how to build this at ground level, where you can put things directly into the dropper. If you wanted to bury this, obviously you need to go one further down than that, but the area you need is 4 long and 3 wide, and it really only has to go down one layer and then an additional one for the lava. The trick here is that you want to be able to put this dropper down, facing down, like that, and then still get back out of here. So I can put these blocks back in now, and you can't put that one in until you've got the lava. So this is a little bit tricky in survival, but certainly doable to do that part. So that's really it. Just have a little bit of lava with a dropper pointing into it. That's step one. Step two, take a comparator off of that, but because one item in a dropper only gives a very weak signal, you need a repeater right after that to strengthen the signal. Now here, you need to run redstone back into the comparator. Because redstone also powers blocks, you could technically save one piece of redstone by doing that. It will still work. The other trick is powering this will cycle the clock, but you also need to power into the block again. And in order to save space, you could normally put a repeater and then a block here, but you need that pulse into the comparator. You could go the other side, but the other thing you can do is just bring a repeater here and use those last two pieces of dust. And that's it. This is a fully functioning device. So if I put that redstone in there, you'll see it pulse through, destroy all of it for us. And of course, if you wanted to bury this, you just put a hopper on it and put a chest on top of that. So that's really all there is to it. This is a quick little dispenser that most people can build in survival. The only tricky bit is getting the quartz for the comparator from the nether. But once you have that, you have a very handy, very safe garbage disposal that won't set your house on fire. That's it for today. I'm Brick Waffle. If you like this video, please do give it a like. That's great. If you really enjoyed it, please make it a favorite. And if you really want to see more from me, please subscribe. I'm very much motivated to do more of these videos. I would love to hear your feedback in the comments. Let me know what you liked or didn't like about this. I have a few more redstone ideas. Obviously, some of these are pretty basic. I want to get a little bit more complicated, but I want to see how this series goes. If you guys enjoy it, please do let me know. Thank you very much.